Okay, here goes the fun times. Now this pump does take a little while to draw up. You know, it's got to come up about 4 feet, I think, from the bottom of this tank. There is a foot valve in there. This thing keeps its prime, which is cool, but that whole pipe is empty of water. So if I remember, it takes a good part of a minute to reach up. But who knows, because I rearranged the pump. Oh, look, it's time already. So all the valves are open. Oops, I don't want this one open. There's the return valve, which I don't want. Turning that off. Now it's forcing water into all these others. Obviously, this is too much water. Let's adjust the flow there. Let's adjust the flow everywhere, because that's going to start happening everywhere. So I'm moving these down to like, oh mama, I don't know, 30%, 50%. Look at that spillover. So the spillover doesn't matter, but I don't want that. I want it to stay in the funnel. This was the issue having a funnel, was that water could spill over. This one's doing pretty well. That one's holding. So you can tell like the flow, you can obviously overwhelm the funnel pretty easily, which is obvious. This guy's overflowing nicely. Oh, sorry, buddy. Now the reason you want to keep things out of the gravel is because wherever water hits, it'll start to form algae. Pretty simple. So even these funnels, I'm gonna have to like shade. I'm gonna put a little like curtain around it or some silliness. There you go. So now everything's kind of equal. All right, cool. So far nothing's blown up. This thing, you know, I don't know, it weighs like 5 to 8 pounds perhaps. This, as you can see, like this isn't super strong, so I might come back and reinforce this little, it's like a little 8-inch ding dong. I'll put a bracket there. Listen to this cute little suction noise. So everything's filling. And then I don't have my siphons. I have my siphons in, but I don't have like the protector over them. Oh, listen to this weirdness. A little hiccup perhaps. Whoops, here's a problem. Oh ho ho ho, look at me just wasting water. That's not what I want. That was silly. Daggone it. This is pretty valuable water. I mean, I've like, you know, it's sat in the tank for a long time. All right, this guy, you know, if you remember, another benefit of having like no closed pipes on the waste is that there's no suction that'll form. So that sturt event, I think is how you pronounce that. That's not an issue. So I just wanna go around and make sure nothing, oh, what do you know? Nothing's spewing out, because that's gonna be an issue. Great gravy. Okay, we got some stuff to fix. No spewage there. See, this pipe was too small. If you notice, it's got this crazy elbow, which I don't care for. Oh, I know what the problem is. I never put the bell siphons in. So, all right. I'm gonna shut this down, do a couple little oopsie fixes, because without the bell siphon in there, you know, without that protective ding-dong, water is just filling the tank and rushing on down. Whereas with the bell siphon control, water will fill the tank and then it'll start to siphon all the water out, but in a periodic way. Okay, well that was exciting. I kind of did foresee running around doing something while that was going. But I don't want to waste this water. So, you know, I gotta remember to keep that thing closed, which is easy. Something's draining, man. Got a siphon going on over here. Yep, so this is siphoning right now, which is cool. This tank was actually full of water, just to make sure I didn't have a leak. So let's see how it's doing. Attaboy. So I don't see any leaks here. This part is not glued, because my thinking was I could pop this off and like, I don't know, tinker, fix things. Everything else is glued, all these joints. But I was hoping that this like boot was enough to hold any water in and help it go down. So the only one it looks like I got to do something with. Oh, this did have the siphon in. Interesting. That's peculiar. The other problem with this one is like it's tilted, if you notice. I couldn't get that super plumb because the bottom of this tank, if you notice, it's like I'm in the corner of this tank. And this tank is tilted on the bottom so that all the water like goes to the center to drain out of these things. So because this wasn't flat in the corner, I didn't realize that it's got a little bit of a tilt to it, which of course tilts the shabba-ding-dong in there. So if that proves to be a problem, I'm gonna have to push on the bottom of this thing. I'm gonna have to push it so it like is a little more plumb. And same thing over here. So I learned a lesson, like I put this one a little further out from the corner into the center so it's less tilted. So hopefully that one will be cool. This one might be problematic. So now becomes the troubleshooting part. Sorry this video is so long, but at least I know this guy works, which is cool. This guy works. And now I just have to like drop the old, I don't know what we really call these things. They're kind of like hoods. But because the whole thing is called the bell siphon, these like, hoods, I don't know, you know, the part that controls the suction out of there, got to put those into play. All right. Thanks.